Your next act, he's really good. He's been here a few times. Every single time I've seen him, he's killed. And I'm very sad because he's moving to Toronto next week.
Ooh.
I know. Which is amazing. You guys are gonna love him. John Ramos!
Hey everyone.
Oh!
Oh! I hate when that happens. Right? You know what else I hate? I hate driving. I give you three main reasons why. Number one, I own a caravan. Can't pick up chicks with a caravan! But you can hit them with it. Now I'm the 16th little child, it gets pretty old. Now,
stop it!
No! Number two, I still can't parallel park and start a lady. It's like almost a bathroom. Park here! No, no, it's too hard. It's too hard. Number three, I hit a really hard van outside in a parking lot for like about 5 hours, right? Because you gotta go to Aldan and buy some undies, you know? And then you come back later on, and like your car has been outside in a sultry heat, you know, for like 5 hours. You open your door, and there's this big heat wave that hits your soul. You're like, ow, my soul! That's what you do when your soul is hurt because of the heat, right? So you air out the inside, you know, you take the door and you're all like, alright. I own a caravan, so sliding doors are like, because, you know, I just want to go inside a car and drive home, you know, and watch my family matters. But I came up with a solution, you know, to help me with my anger. So this is what you do. Next time you know you're going to be leaving your van outside in the parking lot for like about 5 hours, make sure you have a baking pan in there and some cake batter. So 5 hours later, you come back, they're like, oh man, I hate this heat! Hair. But I love surprise car cake. I eat my cake with a microphone! You can bake anything inside your car slash oven. Your car oven. You can bake brownies, cookies, chickens, or if you're an irresponsible parent, a baby. Surprise that babies! Safety first! I'm very inventive. I have a very sick mind. Like the other day, my friend told me to do this, so I'll do it. What's up with Edward Scissorhands? Oh boy, I have scissors for hands! Can you imagine him in elementary school? In the playground? Hey Edward, let's play tag! You're it! No, you're dead. Sorry, teacher. I love school. So I'm like, you know, everyone booed me because I'm going back to Toronto. But just the things that we do in class sucks, like group presentations, right? No, you're in class, not listening to the teacher. And the teacher goes, okay, the next 2 weeks, we're going to be doing some group presentations, right? And from that point on, nobody listens to the teacher, and everyone's like this. We weren't good to everyone. Want to be my group? And everyone's doing this. Moral for moral combat. It's like, bestiality! Fatality! John and Sarah, it's a triangle of love, right? Or a threesome. The teacher goes, okay everyone, remember your assigned numbers. You're one, you're two, you're three. Sorry. You're one? I'm like, no, why am I a two? John, what number are you? You're one, Sarah. You're also one? And I'm looking at all of the twos, I'm like, all the girls gonna be my group, damn it. I see the guy with Norm. We're the same group, then! once to go in the corner. I was at two's one corner. I turn on the retard switch. I'm like, I forgot my number. I think I'm a one. And she's like, no, Dad, you're two. Go over there. Damn it, Professor. So I go to my other girl. I'm like, hey, other girl, nice to meet you. Hey, guy with no arms. No. Hi. Rest. If you're happy, you know to clap your no. And then the other girl is taking initiative. She's like, well, I think if no one wants to be, you know, taking like initiative, I'm going to be the leader of the group. So, Dad, what's your email? What's your email? I'm like, damn it, and I hate giving out my emails because it's a very personal thing. I'm like, okay, well, does everyone have a pen? Oh, God with no arms. Open your mouth. Shut it. Okay. Anyways, my email's Asian boy. No, AZN-BOI _ Dragon Ball Z 69 boobs. Polo ball. Hotmail.com. It's such a ghetto email. I hate it. I love living in a ghetto. Code and Edge, anyone? Does anyone know? Afraid of me, you know, walking home late at night. She's like, done. The reason why I look up, because she's really short, she's like 5 inches, right? She's like, done. Be careful out there. There's a lot of gangsters there. There's a lot of killers there. Like, Mom, don't worry about it, okay? I'm the minority. They should be afraid of me. Here's some examples. Okay, so I came out of Plamondon Metro, right? I was pretty hammered, you know, so I'm walking like this, right? Walking like that. And there's this white dude in front of me, and he's walking, and he sees my... He goes like this, and he starts to run. And in my little Filipino head, I'm like, okay, if a white man is running in the middle of the night and is not jogging, that means trouble. Because something's after him, right? So I'm like running with him, like, okay. Wait a minute. I'm the black guy. So I shot him.